Hello my students, welcome back to the SST classroom. Now my dear students, in the last video we discussed about the lesson number 14, what we do, right? And in that we have discussed the occupation, that is farming. Okay, so let's start the second, that is rearing of animals. Now my dear children, as you all know, various types of animals are reared for a variety of purposes, right? Means animals are cared for the use in the varieties of purposes. Now, rearing of animals is an important branch of modern agriculture. These animals are very useful in the agriculture, right? So, animals are domesticated and their breeding and the living conditions are controlled by humans. Now my dear children, you might be confused about domesticated. So what is the meaning of domesticated? Means animals are trained to work for the human beings. They are well trained, they are trained for the use of human purpose. Right? So my dear children, now cattle rearing consists of rearing animals like goat, cow, buffaloes and bullock. Got it, my dear children? Now, we get a varieties of thing from cattle. You know what we are getting from the cattle? Now, you know what is a cattle? Cattle like goat, cow, buffalo, sheep, etc. Right? You can say the domestic animals, and you all know that domestic animals are very useful for human being, right? So what we get from the cattle? We get a varieties of things from the cattle, right? Goat, cows and buffalo, what they give? They give us milk, right? We get meat from goat and manure from dung of a cattle, right? So bullocks, now the animals like bullocks are used for ploughing, right my dear children? So the practice of rearing animals for dairy products such as milk, curd, butter and cheese is called dairy farming, right? Yes, you all know what we are getting from the animals. We are beside the milk, we are getting many dairy products such as milk, curd, butter and cheese. This is called a dairy farming. Now India is the largest milk producers in the world. In the last video I explained you about that India is the largest producer in the world. India is the largest milk producer in the world. Now dairy farming is one of the important occupation in India.
So students, what is dairy farming? Dairy farming is a type of agriculture that is focused on producing milk. And as you all know, from the milk, so many products are made, such as including milk can be used to produce dairy, including cheese, butter, curd, etc. So my dear students, dairy farming is one of the most important occupation in India. India is the largest milk producer in the world, and dairy farming is one of the most important farming in India. Okay students, I hope you have understood about the dairy farming. Now let's talk about the poultry farming. Okay student, so many farmers have set up poultry farms. Poultry farming is done to get the egg and the meat of hen, duck, geese, etc. Okay students, so my dear students, sheep are the another important animal who are mostly reared in dry and hilly areas. And you know what we get from sheep? We get wool from the sheep. Okay, students, I hope you have understood about the poultry farming. So what is poultry farming? Poultry farming is done to get the egg and the meat of hens, duck, geese, etc. Okay, understood students? Now let's proceed to the another occupation.
No, fishing is another important occupation of the people living near the coastal areas. So the people, those who live near the coastal areas, what type of occupation they do? They mostly, they are engaged in fishing, right? So fishing is their staple food. I have explained you in the last video about the staple. What is a staple means? The food which are eaten regularly. So that is known as staple food. As the people, those who live near the coastal areas, they are doing the occupation of fishing. So you see the fish is their staple food. Okay, dear children. Now we also obtain fish oil from fish, popularly known as called liver oil. So you know what we get from the fish? You all are eating fish, right? So what we are getting, the another thing from the fish, we are getting the cod liver oil. And this fish oil is very important for human beings. Fish are also reared in large tank at fisheries, and this practice is known as fishing farming or pisciculture. So what is pisciculture fishing farming? Means fishes are also reared in a large tank, which you can see here in the images. Fishes are also reared in the large tanks at fisheries, and this practice is known as fish farming or pisciculture. Okay, dear children, I hope you have understood about the fishing. Now you might be have seen that some fishes are salted and packed in tins for selling at a far off places, right? You might be have seen some fishes are salted and they are packed to sell at the far away places. Okay, dear children. So this we talk about today. We talk about the rearing of animals. I hope you have understood about the rearing of animals. So students, now take down your new words. So today new words is, the first one is rearing. So first new word, that is rearing. Second one, domesticated. Third, breeding. Fourth, cattle. Fifth, ploughing. And sixth, poultry. Seventh, dairy farming. And eighth, cod liver oil. And ninth one, pisciculture. Okay, so write these new words in your notebook and read the textbook. Okay, dear children.